Prior to bone pin installation, the middle phalanx must be reduced so placement of the transverse pin does not block joint motion. Proper placement of the pin placement guide on the finger facilitates joint reduction. Remove the transverse pin guide from the pin placement guide and loosen the distal lock screw with the hex wrench. Slide the dorsal and palmar halves of the pin placement guide apart. Place the finger onto the palmar base. The palm of the hand must be parallel with the palmar base. Do not align the fingernail with the palmar base by rotating the finger. Position the finger with the PIP flexion crease aligned with the proximal arrow on the palmar base. Then slide the distal pad until the distal arrow aligns with the DIP flexion crease. When this is done, reduce the subluxed middle phalanx by simultaneously applying manual traction to the fingertip while lowering the dorsal beam onto the finger. Lock the distal lock screw to maintain joint reduction. To confirm correct rotational positioning on the finger, select the dorsal pin and place it into the dorsal drill guide. Then, check the orientation of the pin placement guide on the finger by looking at it from the distal end of the guide. The pin should appear perpendicular to the plane of the fingers. Next, ensure the pin will be placed on the midline of the middle phalanx. Check the position of the drill guide on the finger from the top of the hand. The pin should be centered on the width of the middle phalanx. Proximal distal placement of the dorsal pin is determined by the fracture pattern and is discussed next. For correct positioning of the vertical dorsal pin, adjustment of the dorsal drill guide may be needed. Loosen the dorsal lock screw with the hex wrench. Then, slide the dorsal drill guide proximal or distal as needed to ensure the dorsal pin is placed slightly proximal to the mid-shaft of the middle phalanx but distal to the fracture. Lock the dorsal drill guide by tightening the dorsal lock screw. Use a power drill to insert the pre-drill through both cortices of the middle phalanx. Keep the drill guide aligned with the pre-drilled hole and remove the dorsal pre-drill from the bone. Select the dorsal pin and manually thread it into the middle phalanx by rotating it clockwise into the pre-drilled hole. The pin should extend through the palmar cortex but stop short of the flexor tendons. To install the transverse pin, place the transverse pin guide back onto the pin placement guide. It may be placed on either the radial or ulnar side of the finger. Use the distal proximal and dorsal palmar adjust screws on the pin placement guide to align the metal transverse pin guide tube to a point that is dorsal and proximal to the center of the head of the proximal phalanx. If the transverse bone pin is inserted in the center of the head of the proximal phalanx, it will block the fibers of the collateral ligament and prevent joint flexion. PIP joint motion is facilitated when the transverse pin is inserted dorsal and proximal to the fibers of the collateral ligament. If the transverse pin is placed too far proximal, the device will exert a force that may cause the PIP joint to hyperextend. Repositioning of the transverse pin is necessary. Slide the pin guide tube snugly to the skin and obtain a final lateral fluoroscopic view centered on the tube axis prior to drilling. Continue holding the transverse pin guide snugly against the skin. With a power drill, insert the smooth transverse pin through the proximal phalanx until approximately 1 centimeter of the pin extends out the far side of the finger. Remove the transverse pin guide. Cut the dorsal pin just below its shoulder to allow for pin placement guide removal. Loosen the distal lock screw and remove the pin placement guide from the finger. Select the pin cutoff spacer. Place the thick end of the spacer over the dorsal pin and against the skin of the patient's finger. Cut off the dorsal pin flush with the spacer. Then, place the thin end of the spacer over one end of the transverse pin and cut the pin off flush with the spacer. Repeat on the opposite side of the finger. Select the pin cap applicator and pin caps. Place the pin caps into the applicator with the holes facing each other. Then, align the slots in the pin cap applicator with both ends of the transverse pin. Firmly squeeze the pin cap applicator until both pin caps are pressed onto the tips of the transverse pin. Next, select the TurnKey FCS device. Place the dorsal pin into one of the holes in the underside of the TurnKey FCS, choosing a hole that positions the wire hanger loops directly dorsal to the pin caps. Use the hex wrench to rotate the width adjust screw to ensure the distance between the wire hanger loops is the same as of the pin caps. Linking the device to the pin caps with elastic bands produces a translating force that reduces the fracture dislocation. Select two elastic bands. Install one band between the wire hanger loop and pin cap on each side of the finger. After the pin placement guide was removed, joint subluxation most likely recurred. Use longitudinal traction to prevent damage to the cartilage of the proximal phalanx as the middle phalanx realigns. Evaluate if the initial elastic band tension is sufficient to maintain joint reduction. If not, reapply manual traction while increasing elastic band tension by rotating the tension adjust screw clockwise with the hex wrench. Use the least amount of tension necessary to hold the middle phalanx reduced. Using excessive translating force can damage the collateral ligaments and may result in a palmar dislocation of the joint. Prior to removal, flexion extension lateral x-rays with the elastic bands removed should be obtained to determine if the fracture and soft tissues are adequately healed to maintain a concentric reduction without the device on. This typically requires a minimum of 6 weeks. To remove the device, first lower the wire hanger loops to their lowest position, then remove the elastic bands. Remove the TurnKey FCS device from the dorsal pin. Cut a pin cap off the transverse pin on one side of the finger. Using a large needle holder or similar tool, pull and rotate the pin out of the finger. Using the same tool, unscrew the dorsal pin from the middle phalanx. Place a small non-restrictive dressing over the pin tract holes and instruct the patient to continue with range of motion exercises.